in St. Mary. Today is the optional quarter for John Eudes, priest. Today's Mass is being offered for John Lauriello at the request of Mr. and Mrs. Holdsworth. Your priests, O Lord, shall be clothed with justice. Your holy ones shall bring out their joy.
There is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out at dawn with his laborers for his vineyard. After agreeing with them for the usual daily wage, he sent them into his vineyard. Going out about 9 o'clock, he saw others standing idle in the marketplace, and he said to them, "You too go into my vineyard, and I will give you what is just." So they went off. And he went out again around noon and around 3 o'clock, and did likewise. Going out about 5 o'clock, he found others standing around and said to them, "Why do you stand here idle all day?" They answered, "Because no one has hired us." He said to them, "You too go into my vineyard." When it was evening, the owner of the vineyard said to his foreman, "Summon the laborers and give them their pay, beginning with the last and ending with the first." When those who had started about 5 o'clock came, each received the usual daily wage. So when the first came, they thought that they would receive more, but each of them also got the usual wage. But on receiving it, they grumbled against the landowner, saying, "These last ones work only 1 hour, and you made them equal to us, who bore the day's burden and the heat." He said to one of them in reply, "My friend, I am not cheating you. Did you not agree with me for the usual daily wage? Take what is yours and go. What if I wish to give this last one the same as you? Or am I not free to do as I wish with my own money? You are envious because I am generous. Thus, the last will be first, and the first will be last." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
This is a tough one, isn't it? Because you say to yourself, "Well, I work all day in the field in the heat and the sun and the humidity, and God, I would have expected to be paid a little more as well. If the person ahead of me, who only worked for 1 hour, was going to get the same wage that I received, you probably would think to yourself, you know, just the opposite. Wow, this landowner is generous. I can't wait to see what I'm going to get." And then the disappointment comes. It's difficult in the sense that it kind of collides right with our human, worldly inclinations. But it's not difficult if we step back and look at it from other perspectives of our life, where we would say we want God to be equitable to all of us. We want God to love me and my own foibles and my own troubles and my own inadequacies equally to the point that he loves the person whom I view as being very holy and very close to God. I want the Lord to extend forgiveness to me in abundance, just the way I view that he extends forgiveness to the person that I've been. That person can't even sin. They're one step away from being a saint. And so we look at today's gospel from that perspective, and we see the abundant love, unconditional love, overflowing generosity of God in our lives. And that's also the image of God that we desire at many, many moments of our life. And it's not just an image, it's a reality. The God the Father, through his Son Jesus, pours himself completely out for us, totally and entirely, equally to each one of us as believers. And then comes that other difficult aspect to recognize, that then the Lord wants us to strive to do the same. to be equally a disciple to all those who cross our path, and not to pick and choose. Am I not, the landowner says, free to do as I wish with my own money? Am I not free to be as generous and as selfless and as prudent and as grace-filled with each person that crosses the path of my vineyard? And the same is extended to us, that each person that crosses our path along the journey of faith, each person that crosses our vineyard of the Lord, we're called to be equally just to, and equally honest, and equally caring, and equally forgiving. And that relates to other passages in sacred scripture, doesn't it, that are as hard. It's not an eye for an eye. But it's to turn the other cheek and to be that faithful God of disciple. So as we look at and examine our own lives, it's a good idea maybe today to recognize the moments where God has been abundantly, equally generous and loving and forgiving, and extends his grace to us in abundance. And it's what we would want, and it's what we desire, and it's what we thank Almighty God for. And then in turn, we're invited to do the same and recognize the moments when we have failed to do so, so that we can grow and become a better disciple. Mindful of the many ways in which the Lord Jesus is generous to us, we in confidence then bring to him our prayers and petitions.
For Pope Francis and all bishops, may they be strengthened by the Holy Spirit in their priestly ministry. Let us pray to the Lord. For all world and national leaders, may the Lord open their eyes to the need to treat all their citizens with human dignity. Let us pray to the Lord. For those suffering from illness or hurt, may they find strength in God's infinite love. Let us pray to the Lord. For this faith community, may the Spirit help us grow in faith and virtue. Let us pray to the Lord. For all those who have died, may they find eternal happiness with Jesus, the Good Shepherd. Let us pray to the Lord. For the sick and suffering, Avery Levon, Felicia and Rita Lockery, Kate Long, and all those on our prayer list, let us pray to the Lord. And for John Moriello, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Almighty God, we bring to you these prayers and those that we hold in the silence of our hearts. Answer them according to your holy will for us. We trust that you are good, generous, and abundantly loving toward us through your Son, Jesus, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer to you, through the earth, the work of human hands, and you come for us the bread of life.
Blessed
be
God.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer to you, through the vine and the human hands, will become our spiritual
drink.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty God.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all of his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, the offerings placed on your altar in commemoration of blessed Saint John of Eudes, so that as you brought him glory, you may through these sacred mysteries grant us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift. Since our praises have nothing to do with greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so, in the company of the choirs of angels, we praise you as with joy we proclaim,
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so they may become for us body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, and saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Blessed is the servant whom the Lord finds watching when he comes. Amen, I say to you, he will put that servant in charge of all of his property. For those of you watching virtually, now is the time for you to make a spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I know you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. O my God, my only hope, I have placed all my trust in you, and I know I shall not be disappointed.
Amen.
may partake in